I think these days we're so disconnected from the environment and from the animals around us that we don't really get a chance to communicate them with them that way. And through doing something as simple as building a birdhouse, you are making that connection.
Professor Matt Ruding's fourth year conservation biology class at TRU is applying their classroom knowledge in a very direct way. This birdhouse project, though rather basic on the surface, will likely have a rather noticeable scientific impact on campus.
So we're doing this for a few different reasons. One is that it's a good opportunity to kind of integrate teaching and research. So my main research focuses on studying birds in general and bird behavior. And so we can, by studying these birds on campus, we can integrate this into classes like animal behavior. And for right now, it's for conservation biology as well.
The pine beetle epidemic lay waste to the habitat usually populated by chickadees and nuthatches. So with the restoration of living quarters for these birds, the expectation is they will come back to live and breed right here on campus.
And now as the pines begin to regenerate, we want to be able to see if the nuthatches themselves are beginning to rebound as well. And so by putting up all these boxes and by capturing the birds on campus and banding them, so we really have a good sense of all the birds that we have here, by doing that we get to actually monitor the population over time and see if indeed it is rebounding.
Easy enough?
Well, for any species, I think you need definite baseline data, and it's not something that we really have. So by doing this, we can encourage them to come to the area and to give us that data, and then we can analyze it and work with it and see what exactly they're doing. First, we need the population, though, and for a population, you need housing, and so that's what this project aims to provide.
The benefits of this project are twofold. First, it's to help the birds, and secondly, it's to help the students, who can get their hands dirty and develop their skills in practical applications.
In our classes, we normally do things that are very book-oriented. We do a lot of PowerPoints and a lot of logical conservation work, but doing something like this allows us to actually get our hands on it and feel involved with the surrounding campus and the area, not just the bigger picture. So we actually get to identify local conservation issues and make a difference in those.
Yay!
This kind of project isn't just for university students either. City residents are encouraged to build their own bird box and put them up, where possible, in their own backyard for their own unofficial science project.
And you can just encourage birds to come to Kamloops area as a whole, and that helps people just in their daily lives get interested and invested in the flora and fauna around them, which is, I think, huge in getting people excited about conservation issues, because if you don't see the birds every day, you don't really think about them, and then you don't think about their population or their conservation status.
One of the great success stories with using boxes in particular to gain artificial nesting habitat has been with bluebirds, so with eastern and mountain and western bluebirds. If you kind of go around some of the rural roads around here, you'll see blue boxes out everywhere. These are ones especially that have been put out and maintained by the Kamloops Naturalist Club. And this process goes on all over the country, all over the U.S. as well. And as a result of people putting out all these boxes, we've provided lots of habitat, and the numbers of these birds have increased dramatically over the past few decades. And so this kind of, it's a way for people to get out and actually make a difference by building boxes, putting them out in their backyard, and providing some habitat.
The plan is to measure the bird population late in the fall, with a banding project on the books for November to determine how many birds made TRU their location of choice. I'm Kirk Fraser for Shaw TV.